with you. And the world's all right with me.
I hope you guys are dancing with me. Just one look at you. Guess what? And I know it's gonna be just by looking at you guys.
A lovely day.
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 A lovely day.
Hello, first graders. Let's turn it down. How are you guys doing? Welcome back. Happy Monday. Today's Monday, 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 Monday. All right, let's see what today's date is. It is still January. It is Monday. Oh my goodness. We have Saturday. Do we come to school on Saturday? I don't. All right. We don't come to school on Saturday. We don't come to school on Sunday because that's the weekend. We come to school on Monday. And today is Monday, 25th, 2021. My poor little one. I got to add a one there, okay? Work with me. All right. So it is 2021. Today is the 25th. All right. We have these numbers. I think I'm going to choose one and build it. Since we're working with tens and ones and talking about place value, I think it'll be fun to build one of the numbers. I see 64. Okay. So for the number 64. Okay, we have 64. Let me move it in close for you. And I'm going to make it with tens, put here, and ones. Okay, look at how neat I wrote. Just kidding. All right, so I know that the tens place is over here. So I'm going to do six tens, okay? And I like to do just a little rectangle. One, nice and tall. Two, and thin. Three, four, five, and six. I have six tens because in the tens place, every number has a place. We have six tens, and that six stands for 60 because we count by tens. Look, it's the big brother. 10, 20, 30, 40, 50, 60. Now the ones place, we count by ones. And I like to draw them with small squares. So I can tell what's the difference. I can tell this tall, long, skinny rectangle, it's a 10. I can tell this little square is a one. Okay, so look here, I just built 64. It was one of the numbers on that card. Let's count it. 10, 20, 30, 40, 50, 60, 61, 62, 63, 64. All right, that's our incredible equation. Something I like to do with my class is we make the date. So today's the 25th. Let's make the date. All right, so for 25, we're thinking of different ways to make 25. I want to make it where, okay, 25. I'm thinking of 20 plus 5. And you know why I'm thinking about 20 plus 5? Because on one of your math sheets, that's what you guys had to do. You had to make up equations to make different ways to make a number. So we did 20 plus 5. And look, here's how you draw it out using tens and ones. Okay, if I show this 25 for tens and ones. 10, 20, 21, 22, 23, 24, 25. Look at that. I made it two different ways. I showed you an addition sentence, 20 plus 5. That equals 25. And then I showed you two tens and five ones. Two tens and five ones equals 25. All right, it is time for, let's do the clock. Okay, let's see if you can say the time before I say it. All right, I'm gonna move the time around. We'll move it around and stop. What time is it? Did you say it? I hope you did. 3 o'clock. I'm looking at this long minute hand. It is pointing to the 12th. And I'm looking at the short hour hand pointing to the hour. It is pointing towards the 3. And I know whenever it's at the 12, I say o'clock. So this is 3 o'clock. Let's keep going. You know what? Wait. Do you guys know about half past? Because think of this face of the clock as a big circle. And if I were to cut it in half, think about a pizza, what would half of it look like? Well, the 12 and the 6, it's like almost it's half. I don't know if that helped. I hope it did. That's half. So if I want to say what's half past three, I would move that minute hand halfway past the 3. And what happened? Halfway around, not past the 3. But the hour hand did kind of move. It's in between the 3 and the 4. And we know this one. What is it? Minute hand's at the 6. The hour hand is past the 3, but it hasn't quite made it past the 4. So I know that I'm going to say 3. And what do we say with the minute when the minute hand is on the 6? We say 30, right? So let's say the time together. It is 3:30. Another way to say that is it's half past 3. Did you guys know that? Ha ha, learned something new today. All right, let's try it again. Let's go around to stop. What time is it? You know? Okay, it is 7 o'clock. All right, it's 7 o'clock. And who can tell me what's half past? Half past 7. Think about it. Halfway around the clock. Guess what? Half past 7. So now let's look at our hands on the clock. Let's look at this face. I see that it's past the 7. The hour's hand is past the 7, but it's not quite to the 8. I also notice that the minute hand is pointing straight down on top of that 6. And whenever it's pointing towards the 6, we say 30. All right. So I know that it's half past 7. So it's 7:30. Half past 7 is 7:30. We'll do that again. Don't you worry. We also have a missing equation that we are going to do quickly because we've got to keep moving. All right, we have 4 plus 7. Well, what is 4 plus 7? I know that I like to put 7 in my head, 7, and then I like to count on. So 7, and these are touch points. 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. So when I'm counting, when I'm adding and I'm counting up, I touch the number in a certain point to add. So I'll say 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. There's 4 points on there. So this equals 11. Noun, what plus 9 equals 11 in order to make it balanced? So 7 plus 4, we determined is 11. Okay, now we have to balance the equation because there's that equal sign right there. That tells me both of these things need to equal the same number. So when I'm counting up, I go 9 and then look, 10, 11. Okay, I just added 2. So 4 plus 7 is equal to 2 plus 9. All right, let's add a counter. Oh my goodness. This is so exciting. We are almost to 100. And I can't wait for us to do our countdown. That's coming. All right. I just added a counter. Would you please count by tens with me? Because when we count our days of school, you can see the numbers right here. Working our way to 100. Let's see. Count with me. Start at 10. 10, 20, 30, 40, 50, 60, 70, 80, 90, 95, 96, 97. Oh my gosh, you are 97 days smarter. Oh my goodness. All right, I'm gonna add a counter. Okay, and you might say, what does nine, I gotta add a straw. I added a counter, adding a straw. What does 97 look like? Well, we could build it like this with our tens and ones, or we can represent it with our straws and our sticks or whatever. All right, Miss Gregkowski has a great story that she tells us about the fact family, not the fact family, my goodness, the place value family. Great way to remember all these numbers and the places that they go in. So for 97, there are zero hundreds. There's nothing in the hundreds yet. It will be soon, and we'll find out how many days. But the number 97 has nine tens, and that's just counting by tens. We have 10, so we have nine of these bundles. 10, 20, 30, 40, 50, 60, 70, 80, and 90. So that's the 90. We have nine tens, and then we have seven ones. 91, 92, 93, 94, 95, 96, 97. And let me show you what it looks like in tally marks. All right, look at this. So tally marks, we have 5, 10, 15, 20, 25, 30, 35, 40, 45, 50, 55, 60, 65, 70, 75, 80, 85, 90, 95, 96, 97. Oh my goodness, 97. So if we are at 97 days, 97 days in school, and we are trying to figure out how many more days to 100. Oh my goodness, 97. I'm gonna count up. I love counting up. It's just the quickest way for me. All right, so 97, let's count to 100, and we're gonna start at 97, and that's how we'll know how many more days before we're celebrating and having a wonderful day counting, you know, celebrating 100 days of school. Okay, so 97, and I'm gonna put 97, where do I put it? In my head. So 97, and I'm just gonna draw my dots. 97, 98, 99, 100. How many more days? How many more days? Oh my goodness. 97 plus 3 equals 100. Guess what, guys? In 3 days, you are going to be 100 days smarter. Oh my goodness. I cannot believe it. I love doing calendar with you. You have a great day. Have a lovely day. And it's always a good day to have a good day. All right. Bye, guys. Have a good day.